Hi. I actually just got off the phone with Sahara, and by that I mean I was like, "Hey, Sahara, bye. I need to record a video. I'll call you in a second." So I don't understand why that was important. Anyway, whatever. I did my final, my one final that happened to be today because, of course, the last day, the first day to fucking have the final. Anyway, I spent the entire night listening to sad music, looking at bookshelves and princess dresses. And I think I'm going crazy. Anyway, I have to show you my Pinterest board stuff, because it's extremely important, and if I don't show you, then I'm going to fucking explode. My computer is being annoying. Okay. Just the Pinterest part of my computer. I have a board that's called My Vibe right now, and every so often when I'm feeling a very strong I need to do something vibe, I like update it. There's like three things on it right now, like three different, and then I just put the date and everything. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see this, but this is it right now. Just like bookshelves, insanely blonde hair, masquerade balls, like dark royal-esque rooms, castles. I feel like castles, but like a dark vibe and everything. You know those fantasy books where everybody's dying and the world is in shambles and everybody's hurt and you're like, "Why can't I live here?" Even though you're like, "Honestly, I would die in 2 seconds," but you're like, but it's just, you need to. I've never read Court of Thorns and Roses, but I think people get the same vibe from that book. Have you guys ever read it? I don't know. I have it in my bookshelf. I should probably read that. I tried reading Red Queen at one point. It's not that good. Well, I haven't been able to finish it. I really need to finish the book. I have been trying to read it for years, like since before quarantine years. But oh my god, and there's this one book. Oh my, I wish I had it now. Fuck. Okay, I'm gonna go over to my other house today. Or actually, I can't because I have COVID. I'm gonna get my brother to go over to my other house today and take every single book from my bookshelf so that I can have all of them. Probably not gonna read them, but I need them all. Because Three Dark Crowns. I might just spend a whole day ranting about books. Anyway. Three Dark Crowns is basically about, it's a series, but the first one's called Three Dark Crowns. Anyway, it's about this world where women are more powerful than men, and like women have magic and men don't, and so it's kind of like roles are reversed, I guess, except with magic. And there are like different elements that you can have, and there are three queens. In this one, you can, like, the queens can be any of the elements, really. But in this one, the three queens are poison, nature, and weather, basically. And once they turn 16, they have to fight to the death to see who will become, like, the overall queen, I guess. And it's a huge thing, huge thing. But one of them is has really, really strong powers, and the other two, like, don't have powers really at all, and it's kind of insane. But they have to fake them, and there's stuff about bear attacks and blood magic and like cursed blood magic and stuff. And oh my god, there's a snake called Sweetheart. She dies. It's so sad. And by she dies, I mean somebody fucking kills her. Well, kind of. Anyway, I'm still really sad about that. But there's Arsinoe. Miria and Caitlin. I don't know. Don't ask me. Not the point. Caitlin? Catherine. Miria, I think, and Arsinoe. They fight to the death, and it's this whole thing, and I love it, and it's magic, and it's pain, and it's loss, and like castles and fancy stuff. And I just want to be in a castle and I guess that I don't really want to have everybody around me be dying all the time. That's kind of just what happens in these books. Like, that's not a good part about them, but for some reason it seems worth it. Anyway, I'm kind of going crazy. And I really want to live in a castle with a giant bookshelf and a giant-ass bedroom that's really dark and has one of those giant, like, king-size beds that looks like something a queen would have. And I don't know. I want that. And also the bookshelves. I sent a couple pictures of the bookshelves yesterday to the Discord. And I'm dying and I need them. And also I really want to dye my hair because I love dyeing my hair. But also I really want my hair to go like back to blonde, which it's like, I don't know what fucking color this is. I'm pretty sure this is not my natural hair because it hasn't been growing. The only way I could really figure out what parts of this are natural is if I bleached it, because then the shit that's not, like, my virgin hair would bleach and the other stuff wouldn't. But like, I don't really want to do that because that kind of defeats the purpose. So I actually have no idea. But, yeah. This is actually way longer than my last one. I really want, like, my white hair back. And also, somebody needs to get a snake with me. Oliver, you need to get a snake with me. I've kind of just decided that Oliver needs to get a snake with me, but I guess if any of you guys want to, then you guys could get a snake with me too. Or I guess instead of Oliver. But I was just talking to Oliver yesterday and I was like, Oliver, we need to get a snake together, because I don't even know why I want to get a snake with somebody. I can just get a snake myself. I have a shit ton of research about getting snakes. I know everything there is to know about it. Like, I gotcha. And I want to start reading again. I haven't read in so long and I miss it so much all the time. I spent so long yesterday just looking at, like, book talk because I miss reading so much, yet I can't bring myself to read. Anyway, quarantine hasn't actually been that bad. I've been quarantined before. Like, I mean, I didn't have COVID then, and so maybe it was just worse when I didn't have COVID. I don't know. Honestly, it's not that bad right now. I keep forgetting I'm sick, though, and I'm like, why can't I just go outside and go hang around? And I'm like, I feel fine. Like, why is it such a big deal? And then I'm like, well, if somebody else had COVID, I probably wouldn't want them outside, but I, yeah. Because apparently I'm not allowed to go to the park. That's what my mother told me. Also, what the fuck? Oh, no, I put this on yesterday after I showered. Oh my god, look, I showered, too. Look, my hair, it, like, I should probably, like, brush it or something, but yeah. Also, I think I might cut it. What the hell? I think I might cut it. I'm gonna do, like, layers or something, maybe. I don't know. Should I get extensions? Wait, should I get extensions? Like, should I just, like, get my hair done, like, professionally to get it, like, that color? I don't even remember if you guys remember what the color looks like. Like, this color. Like, white. So I just, like, get it done professionally, and then, like, I can have, and then put, like, maybe extensions in or something. Because, like, I love my hair. But also, and I honestly could not stand my long hair. But sometimes I miss it. I really miss it, even though my confidence is, like, way higher now. And I like myself a lot more now. Which, like, sounds terrible, but I don't know if it was the hair or not that did that. It might just be more me. I don't really know. Oh, also, damn god, this is a lot longer. Honestly, I'm probably gonna still send this, but, like, you guys probably aren't gonna watch it. If you watch it this far, I'd hate to be, like, one of those YouTuber people, but I'm kind of curious to see who's gonna watch it all the way. So if you watch it this far, then comment, like, Beauty and the Beast or whatever. I don't know. I have a Beauty and the Beast poster right next to me. Yeah, guess comment Beauty and the Beast. Anyway, ew, that sounded so stupid. Like, what the fuck? Anyway, I was looking at heels with, like, snakes on them, and not, like, snake print heels, but, like, this bullshit. And I like it, except they're pointy, and I don't do that. And I don't really do stilettos, but, like, that, I like those, too. Anyway, but, like, also, I don't like them because I don't do stilettos. More of, like, a boot person, anyway. And just, like, I never know what keyword search up. So the closest thing I've gotten to what I actually want, it's called Dark Royalty Core. I don't know. It sounds weird, but whatever. I tried searching up snake heels on Amazon, and it did not work. But also, look at this. Look how pretty this is. But, like, it's a little, maybe it's a little bit. I don't really know. I don't know exactly what I want. But I just know I want something. Although, there was this one thing I found that I loved. Loved. I don't know where it is. Anyway. Also, the Windstar website. Constantly looking at that the entire time. I mean, it's more like prom dress type thing. But still. I found nothing good on Shein. Sometimes I'd like just looking there to see for like ideas and stuff. I found nothing good right now. Oh, and antinatalism. I'm an antinatalist. I'm not gonna say I'm proud of it, but I'm not proud of it, so. I honestly don't care. People believe what you believe. I just don't like it. Anyway. But also my TikTok. My motherfucking TikTok. Anyway. Sorry, I was also rewatching some of my TikTok videos yesterday because I did one about like being a Slytherin, and it's like kind of cringy, I know, but I have like a lot of memories tied to it because like it was like a time and I was going through a lot of shit, so I have a lot of memories tied to this particular video and sound and some songs around this time, and it just, there's a lot of nostalgia in it for me. I mean, it makes me really sad in both a happy and sad way. Because, like, it was a really terrible time, but also it kind of, like, gave me hope in that time. I don't know. I can't really describe it super well. But I'm freaking out about Harry Potter because, of course, I am. And this song. Play. Ugh, I want to play. Ugh, fine, it's not playing. Let me go to Spotify. Oh my god, wait, Greek Tragedy? Ugh! That song. Wait, it's like lip play for seconds. Say sometimes that like I can keep myself entertained for a while. This is what I mean. I mean, I'm not even talking to anybody but myself. Really. I mean, kind of talking to you guys, but you guys probably can't watch this.
Smashing likes in karaoke bars, running late with half your makeup on. This method acting might pay harm bills soon enough.
Okay, in this song, skip at all. Skipping different parts of the song. It's so good though. Oh my god, and Lost Boy.
Told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. Promise that I'll never be lonely. Ever since that day. I am a lost boy from Neverland. Peter Pan, and when we're bored, we play in the woods. Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are afraid.
Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like
me are afraid. My hair looks bad though. Me and Pixie Dustin told me to believe, believe in him and believe in me. Together we will fly away in a world of greed to your beautiful destiny.
Okay, sorry, that was a lot of that song, but I love that song. Oh my god, just the whole thing. Oh, and for some reason, Seven by Taylor Swift. Wait, but the song I was actually looking for, the song I was like trying to play earlier when I was like, oh my god, I won't play, is actually, let's see, can I get it? Yes, this one.
The desert in the pouring rain, drank with the devil and forgot my name. Woke with somebody when the morning came. Don't mind, shame me for my youth. Cause I wouldn't be with you. And then I found me a lover who could play the bass. He's kind of quiet, but his body aches. And the days dream and the nights awake. Doing things we know we shouldn't do. Cause I wouldn't be with you. And you can't believe he found me. Wrapped his arms around me.
Oh my god, I don't know if I've ever actually showed you guys the song, but it's not even, it's on Spotify, so let me. It's called Glass Vase Cello Case. It's by Tattletale.
If you want to achieve better results, make a great impression,
and this at the same time at work. Yet.
You should get Grammarly. Mm-hmm. With Grammarly, it's like I have my own personal editor on.
Okay. But, oh my god. Which I know you guys aren't gonna get it unless you see. Okay, but watch But I'm a Cheerleader because. It's so. There aren't really any words, but. Actually, there might be words. No, I think there are words at one point, but I may not remember all the words in the song. It's just like the most fucking saddest thing ever. Okay, it's been almost 20 minutes of me. Sarah's gonna be like, what the fuck? Why are you not calling me back? I thought this was a short video. Yes, but I'm still filming. Sorry. It's not that I'm not calling you back. It's that I'm just like actually still filming it because I'm really. Ugh! And Jess, if you're watching this far, don't watch this part. Oliver, if you're watching this far, definitely watch this part. But this song is like, it's my life right now. So yeah, Jess, please don't watch it. But Oliver did.
I've lost my cool, I'm not sure how to act. Not even sure how I can keep my pride intact. Well, I It's not romantic, I swear. I'm not gasping for air. I want you to be here, but please don't come near. Cause even though I'm pretty sure my head's exploding, I'm not ready for hand-holding. It's not love, I swear. It might be closer to despair.
The whole thing. Oh my god. I just kind of realized that, oh my god, Sahara's calling me because she's probably like, what the fuck? I'm not sure how much you could actually hear because, like, the speakers of my phone are weird and the computer speakers were, like, right by the, like, microphone of my phone. Anyway, not the point. Bye, guys. Love you. Hope you guys are feeling well.